In this video, we're going to be looking at the Path tool inside the Crowd shelf set. First, we're going to drop down a mocap biped from the Character shelf set. We'll just zoom in, and we're going to change the animation cycle from walk to jogging. Let's hit the up arrow key to play it back. Whoops, let's go to change the timeline in playback settings. We'll put it at 1,000 frames, and we'll enable real-time playback. Click Apply, close the window, and let's get started on our crowd. Click on the Populate icon and follow the prompts. So now we've got some agents scattered on our circle surface. And if we take a look at the crowd source node, which is already selected, we can change a few parameters like number of agents. We can also, for example, randomize the size of our agents. And one more thing we're going to do, rename the default state to jogging so that it matches the animation clip we selected earlier. Okay, let's go back up to object level, hit the U key, and click on the Material tab. We're going to assign the material on our agent, which came with the mocap biped. Now click on the Simulate icon so that Houdini will make the necessary node network to simulate a crowd. Let's take a look at our state and behavior nodes. We'll need to change it to jogging. Type jogging, otherwise they're not going to be jogging. And hit the up arrow key to play it back. Well, they're looking kind of weird because they look like they're jogging in water, so we'll need to change the in-place gait speed to compensate and correct the speed of the animation clip. The force parameter in the pop steer wander node will help to push the agents forward. Otherwise, they'll be jogging very quickly on a spot. We can probably move it faster still. Now let's play it back. And that looks okay for now. Let's go back up to object level with the U key. And so what we really wanted to do now that we have our agents is to put down a curve for our guys to run along. So jump to the top view. And let's draw our curve. Press the Enter key to complete the curve, and I'm going to change it to NURBS just for visual effect. You can keep it to polys if you want. Go back to Perspective view, and click on the Path button, select the curve, and hit the Enter key. We can let Houdini name it or put something down. Let's go to the top view and play back our crowd sim. And for the purpose of keeping the video short, I did speed up the playback. Let's stop it and take a look at the Pop Steer Path node. Let's increase the force scale value to 100 and anticipation to 0. This prevents the agents from looking at the path ahead and deviating from their current position. Let's make this force scale to 1000. The joggers weren't really sticking to their path. That's better. And if we want to reduce the gaps between our joggers, we can go into the Crowd Solver node and under Agent Separation, tweak the weight and force scale values. Let's play it back. We'll go into the perspective view. Let's play it back. Oh, and let's go back up to the object level with the U key so that we can see our guy shaded. And that's the Path tool for crowds inside Houdini.